We're very pleased with some of the more recent label extensions, for example, the Spanish label extension, which is really quite significant and something that we're working very hard to replicate in other territories around the world.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Eden Research CEO Sean Smith. Sean, good to speak with you this morning. You've reported a big jump in first half revenue as you continue to clear those regulatory hurdles, and more to come, I should imagine.
Yes, good morning, and thank you for the invitation to be here. Yeah, we were reasonably pleased with the progress we've made in the first half. For those who follow the story, they'll realize that it's always a story of two halves, as is any interesting event. But in any case, we were pleased with the progress that we've made. We've seen good fundamental growth year-over-year from our core business, which is specifically the products that we have registered now. And a lot of that growth is actually coming from growth for new applications for the product itself and strong fundamental underlying growth in the products themselves. In addition to that, we've had some benefit from new product introductions where we were able to realize an amount of revenue early in the year, which is obviously very helpful. Apart from the numbers alone, we've been very happy to see some good progress on the regulatory front. And for those who are relatively new to the story or have forgotten, the long and short of it is that regulatory approvals are our lifeblood. They are what ultimately drives the growth of our business. And so when new authorizations come through from the regulators around the world, for example, California, Germany, et cetera, these really are major milestones in the sense that they introduce new opportunities for us. They expand our overall addressable market, and fundamentally, they drive sales.
You mentioned the approval for Mevalone in California. You also had those label expansions in Spain, Germany, and Czechia. And you do say in the results that you're working with your partner Sipcam to look at South America as well, so Argentina, Brazil, and Chile. So a lot more to come then on that side, Sean.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, the regulatory process is a difficult one to predict. We never know what the timing is going to be precisely, because of course these decisions are in the hands of the regulators. What we do know is, you know, these cases are being worked on. We do know that there's progress being made. To give you a really good example of how that works, when we received authorization from Poland some time ago, we really expected authorizations across the rest of the central zone in the EU within 120 days, because that's what the regulation requires. But of course, in reality, that happens very, very rarely. And of course, Germany and the Czech Republic were far later than that 120-day window. So again, you know, stay tuned. We have quite a lot of regulatory action ongoing at the moment. We've recently strengthened the team on the regulatory front, and we'll continue to make progress, as and when and as quickly as we possibly can.
You also make mention of Ecovelex. Can you tell us what you're planning for that at the moment?
Yeah, so with Ecovelex, we continue to work with Corteva, our partner on that project. We were successful in securing an emergency use late last year for use in Italy. Seeds were treated. I think it was approximately 225,000 to 250,000 hectares worth of maize were planted across Italy. And, you know, what we've been very happy with the developments on that front. We intend to continue to pursue these opportunistic, if you will, regulatory authorizations in territories where there are no reasonable alternatives available to growers. And so, of course, what that means is that we are pursuing additional emergency approvals for the upcoming growing season, in other words, the 25 growing season. As with all regulatory action, we can't anticipate whether we'll be successful in doing that or not. Most of the times we've pursued those, we have been successful, but not every time, and there are never any guarantees. So if all goes to plan, we should see a repeat of what happened in late 23 for the 24 growing season, which will have an impact on us in 24 and into 25.
You talked about expanding your team, Sean, so commercial laboratory teams as well as regulatory. And that's obviously put pressure on margins in the short term, but I should imagine you'll get long-term gains from that.
Ultimately, we had remained light on the commercial side of things out of necessity, really, and in an effort to conserve cash to the greatest extent possible. But there is a point at which that becomes a little bit of a diminishing return. And what we began to realize is that we needed more horsepower on the commercial side of things. And so we've been very fortunate to appoint two very experienced individuals, one of whom has a tremendous amount of experience with Mevalone itself, even down at the farmer level, understanding the product and the opportunities associated with the product from a grower's perspective, which is very helpful for us. And the other gentleman having, you know, more than 12 years of experience with Syngenta, getting really good exposure to both the conventional pesticide market and the biocontrol side of things. So some very good perspective. And we're already seeing the benefit of that, bringing this additional expertise, this additional resource to bear, very much focused on growth. And that, of course, is always going to be the primary role of your commercial team, is to drive growth. I'm very happy to say that we now have that additional resource available to us, which will allow us to pursue opportunities that we were having to set aside due to a lack of resource.
Sean, so after growing revenue by 65% to $1.89 million in the first half, on track to meet your full year targets?
That's exactly what we're anticipating. But as I said earlier on, you know, it's always a year of two halves. And so it right now is premature to say how the second half is going. We believe that we're very much on track. But as a point to highlight, as we did last year, some of those performance and figures that we're anticipating for the year are tied to regulatory approvals. And so if those come through, we're in very good shape, particularly if they come through on a timely basis. And if they don't, well, you know, we will be where we are. But what I will say is overall, we're pleased with the progress we've been making. We're very pleased with some of the more recent label extensions, for example, the Spanish label extension, which is really quite significant and something that we're working very hard to replicate in other territories around the world.
So I'm sure we'll be chatting again very soon. Thank you very much for the update today.
Great. Thank you.
That's Sean Smith, the CEO of Eden Research. We'll be right back.